Hi everyone and welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going to be going over the origin, the insertion and the action of the vastus lateralis.
Here we can see pictured the vastus lateralis, and the vastus lateralis is the largest of the four quadricep muscles. The other three quadricep muscles are the vastus intermedius, the rectus femoris, and the vastus medialis. Now we can see the vastus lateralis amongst the other muscles of the thigh, and you can see why it gets its name, because it's the most lateral of the quadricep muscles as well as being the largest. And you can see just lateral to it though, you've got the iliotibial band, also known as the IT band here, and just medial to it, you've got the rectus femoris muscle. The vastus lateralis origin is going to begin on the anterior femur and then work its way round to the posterior of the femur. So you can see I've got highlighted here in red either side, the anterior portion of this origin, which begins on the greater trochanter and the intertrochanteric line. Swapping to a posterior view, you can see the remainder of the origin, and that's going to be on the gluteal tuberosity and the lateral aspect of the linea aspera. So you can see again, I've got highlighted in green the vastus lateralis, and this is to illustrate our next point of origin, which is the lateral intramuscular septum of the thigh. And this is a deep fold of fascia, and it's between the vastus lateralis and the biceps femoris. So highlighted here in green, we've got the biceps femoris muscle. Next to it, we've got the vastus lateralis muscle, and then just lateral to that, we've got the iliotibial band. So between the vastus lateralis and the biceps femoris, we've got that lateral intramuscular septum of the thigh. So that's separating the anterior compartment of the thigh from the posterior compartment of the thigh. And of course, it also serves as that origin point for the vastus lateralis muscle. Moving on to our first point of insertion next, it's going to insert on the lateral aspect of the patella. As for the remainder of the insertion, the quadricep muscles are all going to come together and form a common tendon, which is called the quadriceps tendon. This quadriceps tendon is then going to insert into the patellar tendon, or the patellar ligament, depending how you want to call it, which comes down here and connects onto the tibial tuberosity, which I've marked out in blue on the other side.
So we're back again with the skeletal model. Let's take a look at the actions of the vastus lateralis muscle. So it's coming down the lateral side of the femur here, and it's crossing over the knee joint as well as the other quadricep muscles. So it's going to work together with them to contribute to extension of the knee joint, which is when the knee straightens just like that. And the vastus lateralis is actually the strongest extender of the quadricep muscles because it's also the largest quadricep muscle. It's also going to work alongside the vastus medialis to stabilize the knee joint because the vastus lateralis is on the outside and the vastus medialis is on the inside. So if you found the video helpful or you enjoyed it, you know which buttons to press. Press these buttons down there, really helps our channel. I've got links in the description box below to the other quadricep muscles, and I've also got a link to the website where I've got a full article on the vastus lateralis muscle. So if you want to go into more detail and learn more about the muscle, check out that link as well. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you all next time.